Rothamsted Research is the largest and oldest agriculture research institute in the UK and probably in Europe. We've traditionally been a very inventive organisation that has influenced the way agriculture is practised. And now, moving into the 21st century, we're developing all the modern tools of genetics and genomics in order to improve crop plants. Rothamsted Research is funded predominantly by the BBSRC. We have three sites, and overall we have approximately 500 people employed. We specialise in the development of arable crops in the UK, particularly in wheat and oilseed rape, and we have a strong tradition as well through Broom's Barn, working on sugar beet.
Well, Rothamsted still has a major research effort focused on wheat, focused on improving the quality of the crop, the productivity of the crop, its resistance to stresses, diseases, pests, all elements of crop production. And this research is ongoing at the moment with international effort and collaborators as well.
I think the major challenges facing agriculture, we see it as a perfect storm in a way, are the issues of food security, environmental protection, and dealing with the issues of climate change and the carbon economy. We are doing work in the area of biofuels, and this is a bit of a controversial area because many people worry about the competition between acreage for food crops and acreage for biofuels. We have taken a bit of a different approach at Rothamsted by the development of cellulosic biomass through very rapidly growing trees, using willow as an example.
So our part of the centre is to concentrate on the crops of willows, fast-growing trees, and also miscanthus grass, which is a tall, exotic grass that also grows extremely quickly. And the point about these is this willow, if you take a stick no longer than this, poke it in the ground, within a period of only 4 years, you get not only one stem, but between 5 and 10 stems that are up to 5 metres in height, so taller than this room. So you can imagine a plantation of willow with these stems of 5 metres high and how much woody biomass that produces in a very small area of land. And what we're using this woody biomass for already is in combustion to produce heat and electricity. Now, fuels at the moment, liquid transport fuels, can be made from plants, but that's coming from sugars or starches or even oils that are readily available in plants, and that tends to be food crops. So at the moment, all of our biofuels, as they're called, that are coming from plants, come from food crops because they make readily available sugars that we can easily get hold of. Now, trees and grasses also have sugars, but they're locked up in the cells, in the stems of these woody stem pieces like this. So we need to be able to get methods to release those sugars from the cell walls, and that's more tricky, and that's where the research comes in.
Rothamsted can address these challenges both from the points of view of developing new technologies, but in addition, we are very committed to the idea of translating these technologies into the user sector, whether that be in the UK and Western Europe, or in fact in the developing world. And we have quite a few major projects, for example in Africa, in which we use techniques that are now low-tech but were developed using high-tech methods that we can now introduce into Africa, into nations where they have yields that are much lower than the yields that we would accept in this country. But at the same time, we can double and triple their yields using very simple interventions. We need to develop science that is relevant and likely to move out of the laboratory and into common practice in agriculture. And consequently, simply being in regular contact with the industry is a critical factor because it does keep us grounded on the things that are most important to the agricultural community. But in addition, we are a bit of an engine for innovation, and we do develop science that the industrial companies want to license. and some of the technologies that we are developing now, we would love to see develop as spin-outs that could then become employment hubs in appropriate centres in the UK.